everyone. It's not working. So we open the doors. If anyone looks like they're nodding off, let me know. I'll talk louder or something. Oh, we heard it. Okay. Most of you know about lifespan or have heard about lifespan. So anyone who has not? Good. Okay. I'll share some information on that because it's probably the most significant development in sort of aging deferral science that has come this way as yet. And it's going to challenge your thinking probably, because just imagine that you could do something that was going to extend your healthy life by 10 or 20 years. It's a pretty fanciful thing to say to someone, but believe me, this is exactly what this product can do. It's pushing back the aging, and it's pushing back death, and it's pushing back the disease process. And there's a massive amount of science to back that up. That's not just my claims. I won't be showing a huge amount of science tonight. We'll go into it a little bit, but time prohibits. But if you really want to challenge what I say, be skeptical as you like, I would totally suggest you do, and find out about it, because there is nothing ever been released on the market like this product. And I'm 100% certain of that. Let's talk about health in general first. We are naturally designed to be healthy. We are not designed to get sick and to die early and to be miserable and have all the health problems that are going around at the moment. And they're just increasing. One of the reasons, it's patently apparent that the medical system as we know it is absolutely hopeless at dealing with degenerative disease. You go to a doctor with diabetes, and he won't even try and fix the diabetes. He will try and modulate your insulin, try and push back any of the side effects like circulatory problems and whatever else may occur. But as far as getting rid of the disease, it's just not going to happen. They're not even thinking about it. And you know, cancer, heart disease, they do a little bit with heart disease, they'll stick a stent in or cut you open and do a bypass or whatever. But is that really fixing the problem? It's clearing out some arteries. But we've got a medical system that's taking up billions and billions of dollars. They're talking about putting up the GST from 10 to 15% for all of us. Thank you very much. And it was first proposed by the Premier of New South Wales. Why? Because they have no way of coping with the health costs. With the aging population, us baby boomers, you know, we're going to send the country broke. So what are they going to do? I'll put tax up 50%, one hit. That'll solve it. We've got massive, massive structural problems in our health system. And we're spending more and more money diagnosing and treating. And I'm not anti-medical, because there's been phenomenal steps made forward in the medical industry over the last 50 years. There's surgery and emergency interventions, and you know, they can keep you alive a lot better and get you back and do amazing things that would have been miracles 30 or 40 years ago. So there's been tremendous advances in many parts of medical science, but there's been virtually zero advances in handling degenerative diseases. So, you know, you go along with asthma, the doctor's not going to try to fix the asthma, he's not going to try to fix the diabetes. They're managing it. And that to me is a massive problem, because I'll show you some statistics later, that we are about 80% certain of going down that severe degenerative disease pathway unless we do something about it. And I sort of got into the health business because my partner Debbie got awful sick. She would be diagnosed today with severe chronic fatigue. This is 25 or more years ago, maybe 30 years ago. And we went, you know, I wasn't into health, I just got a little along with the doctor, and the doctor said, I'll go and see this specialist. Oh, that didn't work, go and see this specialist. And so we did we'll do some exploratory surgery, cut her open, see what's in. Yeah, oh, I can't find anything. And I'm saying, what the hell's going on here? But, you know, this is years of medical treatment, and we're getting nowhere. And And that's pretty much how it goes with most degenerative diseases. And then we went along and saw an acupuncturist and got a good result. Then we saw a kinesiologist, and then we saw a few other people. And all of a sudden, we started getting good results. And I'm thinking, what's going on here? Because when you really look at it, if you get something seriously wrong with you, you can't trust the medical system. I'm not knocking the doctors. They're fantastic people. They work really hard. But the system is so bad for degenerative diseases. There's only one logical, rational thing to do, is don't get it in the first place. It's called prevention. Everyone talks about prevention. It's like the weather. Everyone talks about it. No one does anything about it. Because what is prevention? Prevention, to my mind, is dealing with a subclinical deviation from ideal health before it becomes a disease. So if you've got perfect health there, you've got death there, about there, you start getting symptoms, you go along to the doctor, and if the doctor can take the symptoms and say it's a disease, they get interested and they start giving you drugs or getting you surgery or go to a specialist or whatever doctors do. But there's that area between perfect health and diagnosable disease that is the key to prevention. That's the subclinical area. That's where you start correcting things before they become a big problem. And that's what I've been involved with. I sort of fell into it in a lot of ways, but we've been involved in natural health now since 1992. And our specialty, if you like, that we've developed over those years is detoxifying people and getting some nutrition into them, because frankly, we are just 50 trillion cells. They all talk to one another. They're all independent little life units. The cells can live by themselves if they're in a dish with enough nutrition and get rid of their waste. So we've got 50 trillion of these things. They're stuck together, and we think we're one magnificent individual. But we're really 50 trillion individuals that are really good at cooperating. Pity our 6 billion people can't cooperate that well. So really, underlying most diseases are two reasons. That each of those little cells either have insufficient nutrition, in other words, there's not enough fuel going into the cell for it to work properly, or there's too much crap from the outside called toxicity that's impairing the cell from doing its function. And basically, there's not very much else that causes disease. So the medical system tends to want to diagnose the disease, put a label on it, and then fight the disease. The philosophy I've aligned myself with over the last 20 odd years is to say, hey, parts of the body aren't working. There's got to be a problem. There's either too much toxicity in some of the cells or not enough nutrition. So if we can clean the cells out and we can get some good nutrition in, the body will probably look after itself, and that's pretty much what we've found. There's always exceptions, and things don't work and things do work. But overall, we've got some pretty amazing results over the 20 odd years just by detoxifying people and getting some good quality nutrition. And we've invested in some pretty cool technology to identify these subclinical changes that are happening in people and sort of head the problem off of the past, because that's what we need to do. Now, my take on how the body works is probably a little bit different. You won't see this chart on any GP's wall. But we have here our genes. Our genes are our recipe book for life. We've got 20,000 genes, and they're in every cell, and every cell you've got your chromosomes. Those chromosomes can spread out to about a meter long, and it's all genes, and that's the code of life. Okay, we were told last Thursday that there's the equivalent of 12 Bibles or something in each gene code. So that's what we are blessed with at conception. As soon as we're conceived, the two cells come together, we've got our gene code set. Now, the interesting thing is how that gene code is interpreted. It's like on MasterChef. Some guy comes in with his beautiful dessert, and the contestants say, here's your ingredients, here's your recipe, go away and make us replicate this. They don't always do it, do they? And that's a little bit like the genes. It's like saying, hey, here's the recipe, but it doesn't always come out right, and that's because of the interpretation of the recipe. And that's how our genes work, because we've got the code, but it's how that code is translated into life And that's called gene expression. It's how those genes are interpreted and acted upon that determines our life. So we've got our cells, we've got the gene code, we've got the gene expression, which is affecting that. The toxicity, which can be chemical and emotional. A lot of people suffering from emotional toxicity. Mm-hmm. And you've got nutrition. And that then results in cellular function, and that then determines how well our life is going or not. So my take on it is that if we can get the cells functioning at a better level, and the three factors that are impacting it are gene expression, nutrition, and toxicity, you're probably in a position then where you're doing something very positive in a preventative fashion. Okay, there was an experiment done, started nearly 30 years ago by Professor Rick Weindrick in the Wisconsin Primate Center. And what Dr. Weindrick did was to determine the long-term health effects of a strategy called caloric restriction. They got 76 monkeys, rhesus monkeys, divide them into two groups, and one group just led their normal life, did what monkeys do, ate bananas, swung on trees, whatever else in the primate setter. And the other one had exactly the same diet, except they had 30% less. Okay? And that went for 20 years. It was reported in one of the top two scientific journals in the world. And what they found, in summary, is that the ones on caloric restriction were going to live 10 or 20 years longer. They had half the incidence of cancer. They had a total elimination of diabetes compared to the control group. Reduced autoimmune disease, half the chance of cardiovascular disease. Their brain atrophy was decidedly less. Brain atrophy is shrinking of the brain, Alzheimer's. Chronic inflammation was reduced, and muscle wastage, which is the scourge of older people, was also reduced. That's from just eating 30% less. Anyone want to cut their food by 30% for the next 20 years? Come on, there must be someone. Okay, but it's proved categorically that these health benefits can be achieved. And around the time they were doing that, gene chip technology came in, and this is where they can assess the expression of the genes on that little chip. And there's 25,000 genes, and you can see how they're expressing, whether they're hot and active or whether they're cool and inactive. And the interesting thing they can then do is say, okay, have a cup of coffee, take another drop of blood after the cup of coffee, and compare the effect that the coffee has on the genes, or a vitamin, or anything else. So it's opened up a massive new realm in science. And they found that the control group of monkeys had a very different gene expression profile to the caloric restricted group. Dramatically different. So they were same monkey, same genes, same diet, but over 20 years their gene expression profile and their health was dramatically better. So then some smart guy said, what if we can get a botanical intervention of some kind that produces the same gene expression result without people cutting their food by 30%? Good question. And so the next 7 years they spent testing ingredients to the point where they came up with series of ingredients that combined produced the same gene expression changes as the caloric restriction did. Pretty hard to get your head around, I know. And the product is called YSPAN. We use that. The whole idea of it is to extend your youth span. Now, if I sat down and asked each one of you, especially those, if there's anyone here over 50, I don't know, but if anyone is over 50, if I said, are you really concerned about how long you want to live? Most would say, not that fast, but I would like to be okay while I'm here. You don't want to be in a mess, in a wheelchair, in a bad way for 20 years of your life. No one wants that. So this is the difference between lifespan and youth span. The youth span is the time that you can live in a youthful fashion, And we want to extend that as much as possible. And that's the purpose of this revolutionary supplement. It's to extend the time with which you can enjoy life. And it will probably, if it's the same as the caloric restriction, see a 20 or 30% increase in the length of time that you live anyway based on what happens with the monkeys. That is pure science fiction. You know, 12 months ago, the concept was science fiction. There was no chance of ever doing it. And now, after cumulatively over 30 years of research, we've got a product that has been proven to do exactly that. There's clinical trials, there's gene expression trials, there's all sorts of things showing that it will dramatically increase your chances of living longer and living better. And one of the things is, this is a biophotonic scanner. It measures your antioxidant levels in 90 seconds, less I think that one. The Y-span doesn't have a lot of antioxidants in it. It has a money-back guarantee. If you test yourself, go on the Y-span for 2 or 3 months, I'm not sure which, and your score doesn't go up, the company will give you your money back. Three, thank you. That's remarkable because your antioxidant level is one of these subclinical biomarkers that are really an important indicator of your long-term well-being. You know, blood pressures like that, there's all sorts of things. So for something as significant as your antioxidant level would be 100% guaranteed. I've been taking the LifePak product for 8 or 9 years now and got phenomenal results out of it. My score went up and then stabilised for the last 5 years. When I went over Y-span, my score went up 60% in 3 months.
Wow.
That got my attention because if my antioxidant level suddenly jumped 60% in 3 months, that is telling me that something really, really significant is going on in my body, and it's a good significant, not a bad significant. Okay, so we've also got some equipment where we can scan what's going on in the body using Russian technology, and fundamentally what you get is you put some headphones on and it's leaking into the field in the body, and on the screen of the computer we get a diagrammatic representation of any part of the body that we choose to look at. So I've been using this for 5 or 6 years. It's very good for a whole lot of things, but we got a small sample of the Y-span back in about May, and I started testing it against people because we can test. You know, if you're a doctor, you could test drugs and see if the drug had an effect. If you were trying to fix someone's liver, you could put a sample of the drug in there and see the effect it had. And I started playing with the Y-span, and it's nothing short of remarkable. And it's proven to be that. I've just seen result after result after result. The significance of those results I've never seen from anything else in 6 years. So that certainly got my attention. These are the figures I was telling you about. This is the Australian Bureau of Statistics. 147,000 deaths in 2012, and basically 81% of them were degenerative disease. So if you just sit there and do nothing, buy a bit of fruit and vegetables from the fresh fruit people, have your McDonald's, drink your coffee, do all the normal things we do in life, which is most of the population, that's what you're heading for. It's a sad, sad situation. I believe, you know, getting some good nutrition, taking something like Y-span, you could probably take your chances from 80% down to 20%. Is that worth the price of a cup of coffee a day? I think so. You may not. It's up to you, it's a personal choice. But that's what the Y-span will cost you net, around about $4 a day. You talk to someone who's got a horrendous degenerative disease now and say, if you could spend $4 for the last $4 a day for the last 5 years to avoid this, would you have?
Yeah.
These are the parts of the body that it's been proven and shown to affect: the brain, the heart, the skin, the physical performance, bones and joints, antioxidant protection, immunity, eyes, cellular response, lipid metabolism, systemic balance, DNA integrity. Nothing important. So find out about it. I don't expect you to rush out and spend X dollars on Y span as a result of me today. Talk to the person who invited you. Sit down and find out what the studies are and get more of an idea about it. But the way I see it, your choices are to do nothing and take your chances, eat 30% less for 20 years or get some lifespan if you want to improve your chances of living longer and better. Pretty much a no-brainer. So I don't think people say it's a supplement. I call it a supplement system because I honestly believe it is a very complex range of functions that it's dealing with, a complex range of ingredients. So it's more of a system than one particular supplement. It's not like taking vitamin C or zinc or something like that. And believe me, I've just never ever seen, and no one, you know, I've been selling supplements for 25 years. No one has even made a claim that there any form of supplement can do what this has been proven to do. It's pretty remarkable. So, all I'd suggest, don't listen to me, don't believe me, find out about it for yourself. But if you do nothing after tonight, well, that's your choice as well. So, the Y-span will, obviously it's focused on gene expression, it provides nutrition and helps with detoxification. I found personally quite a few people who, we had a trial, some of us got the Y-span early back in September, quite a lot of people had healing crises, which I think are a very positive thing. You know, I had one guy who couldn't get off the toilet for a few days. People had headaches. Now, I started coughing. Coincidentally, if you listen to the old homeopaths and people like that, they'll say, you know, the deeper you go into a health imbalance, the longer it takes to get out, and you will often replicate the symptoms that you had going into the health situation as you come out of it. And I started coughing. I had a major lung problem when I was 3 years of age. Could have incapacitated me quite badly. And, you know, I started on the Y-span all of a sudden. I started coughing. But I wasn't sick. You know, you get an infection and you feel like you've got an infection. I was just coughing up some crap. And even Demi said to me, "You're coughing all the time. What's the problem?" I said, "I reckon it's just the Y-span cleaning me out." She said, "No. Been going for 2 weeks, you've got a bug." All right. We have interesting conversations. I went away for 3 days and forgot the Y-span and stopped coughing. When I got back, started taking the Y-span, I coughed for another week. That proved to me that it was just a normal cleansing, a healing, called a healing crisis by the homeopaths. And that's a very, very positive thing. And I saw so many of these because people would get symptoms, but they wouldn't be sick, as a general rule. If you get a symptom where you feel, you might feel nauseous or headache or whatever, but you don't feel sick, it could well be a healing crisis as a result of toxicity coming out of your system. So that was very impressive. Who would like some? Talk to the person who invited you here today, because it is unlike anything else on the planet. And I owe it to yourself to find out about it. If you're going to live a lot longer, you probably need some bucks to keep you going. If you're still racing mountain bikes when you're 95 years of age, or buying Harley Davidsons, or travelling, you'll probably need some more money. And that's the business aspect of this, which Kaz mentioned before. Financial security to me is being able to live the life you choose. Now, if you want to go and live in a mud hut in Tibet, that's fine, you probably don't need a lot of money. If you want some of the better things in life, some of the material things in life, or you want to travel or whatever, you probably need some money. I don't know anyone who's got too much money. We were very fortunate on Thursday and Friday to listen to a guy called Anton Bonnet, who's built a massive business. And Anton is making, I understand, $450,000 for the month. It's a massive amount of money, and he's been incredibly successful doing what people have never been able to do. Doing a huge, huge, huge business. He would have hundreds of thousands of people in his business environment. He didn't complain about having too much money. He's pretty comfortable with it. He didn't say, "Hey, I'm sure he's giving it a lot to charities and some of the New Skin Foundations and where we feed starving children, all that sort of thing. But, you know, it's being able to do what you want in life. And that is only achieved by one thing, and that's royalty income. Because if you're working as a doctor or a top lawyer, you might be making $1 million a year. But if you're working 80 or 90 hours a week to do it, I don't think that's a good lifestyle. You've got plenty of money, but no time. And there's quite a few people doing that. The trick is to have money and time. And that can only be achieved by royalty income, because if the doctor stops working, he's 80 or 90 hours a week, the income goes down pretty quick. Whereas, you know, traditionally we've generated royalty income by lump sum investment in the bank. Put $2 million in the bank, get 3%, you've got $60,000 a year royalty income. You don't have to go anywhere to get it. It just goes into your bank account. The other way that works well is I tell the story, everyone's heard of Don McLean, American Pie. He was unknown, wrote American Pie in 1969 or 70, one of the biggest hits of all times. No one understands what the words were about. Might have been some pharmaceutical influence in the words. But he was asked, he said, what does American Pie mean? He said, American Pie means that I've never had to work again, unless I felt like it. Because every time someone plays the song on the radio or buys an album or whatever, he gets a royalty. And he's had, like all the top musos, the ones who've written the songs are the ones who make all the money. So he's lived his life ever since 1970, completely financially independent, does whatever he likes. Buys a better quality drug, I don't know. Most of us can't write songs. Most of us can't do things like that. But you can, if you get into the right business model, and this is where I'm going to challenge you to open your thoughts a little bit, you can create royalty income, because that is the key. To be able to, you know, Pauline went and did something in the jungle because she felt like it a year or two ago. She was able to do it because she had royalty income. She didn't have to go to work every day. And one of my favorite words, and it really sums up a lot in life, is perspicacity. It's the ability to discern what is really going on where others might only see the surface clues. So Anton Bondo, who's earning $450,000 a month, 20 odd years ago, was a very successful businessman. He had 5 wholesale jewelry businesses in Europe. He was doing well. Why did he give all that away to talk to people about face cream, or whatever it is? Because he could see the potential. He could see the aging population. He could see that people were wanting to fight the aging process. And he could see that the company had the technology and the answers to merge those together. And he could then build a business that, you know, his five jewelry business, I'll guarantee he wasn't making 450 grand a month. But he let all that go and went into this business because he could see things that most other people couldn't see. And he doesn't try and convince people to join the business. He'll tell someone about the business and how it works, and they'll say, I don't think that'll work. And he'll say, yeah, you're probably right, and walk away. And that's probably the best approach. But it's seeing what really is there and not wanting the previous conditioning limits you too. Let's say you want some royalty income. Do you think over a period of time that I or you could find 10 people who wanted to buy that on a regular basis?
Yeah.
It's not a big deal?
Easy.
It's not a big deal, is it? And they might want to get some hand cleaning or some cleanser toner to use with their age like me. Do you think you could find 10 people over a period of time who would want one of them? Would anyone offer me some money for this tonight? Because it's not mine and I could sell it. The people I've been telling about this are very keen to get their hands on one. Now, if they buy that, they then have to buy them, which is understandable. And do you think you could find 10 people over a year or so who might want to buy that system and would consume the product? Anyone got a problem with that? I don't think it's a big deal. Do you think you could find four people who'd like a royalty income of $50,000 a year? And thought that they could find 10 people who'd want one of them, and 10 people who'd want to buy that? Because if you do that, and they do the same as you, you've got a royalty income of about $4,000 a month and $50,000 a year. Do you think that would be easier than accumulating $1.7 million after tax in your bank account? Because you need $1.7 million after tax in your bank account to produce $50,000 a year. No one's voting for 1.7. I'm not voting for